Hello guys, welcome back to Tax Writers. In this video, we want to continue our work on the post-processing of the Floyd field and its visualization by streamlines. So what are streamlines? Streamlines are a common way, a very common way to visualize fields, especially Floyd fields, in which you visualize, in which you trace. It's like, as the name implies, it's a sort of tracing for different lines or different streams in the Floyd. So it says that if you, for example, put some particles in, for example, in the inlet of the domain, what happens to those particles? And this is indeed a way of visualizing the path that those particles will take through the when they want to move around this field, in this case the velocity field. There is also another technique for visualization of such cases, which is indeed particle tracking, but I will describe it in another video. In this video, we want to focus on these stream traces or streamlines. So let's go to ParaView. I will start from scratch, but I have described these steps in the previous video in details, and how to create this field, the scalar field, and also how to post-process the distance function, how to deal with the distance function. So I quickly do that again here. The field. So I import the simulation. As I told you, the simulation is something that is indeed parallel. It consists of 170 different submeshes, but ParaView is just assembling them together by the help of that PVD file. So I go for the visualization of my scaffold here, which is just something spherical object. So this is indeed the object, the degrading object that I have. But in addition to that, I create a new vector field by having the definition of the components of the Floyd flow and taking advantage of this calculator filter. So when I click apply, let's also rename it to velocity. When I click apply, I have a new variable called velocity, which is indeed the representation of the velocity field, which is indeed a vector variable and not a scalar one. So this is what we have, and when we have something like this, so a data set that contains a vector variable, you can see that we have new filter enabled. In this case, stream tracer. When I select the one that contains the vector field, you can see that now I have the stream tracer enabled. When I click on this, you can see that it allows me to select a line, which is indeed the origin of those stream traces. And it says that I want to create the streamlines over this line. It acts as a seed of this stream tracer. Let's click apply and see what happens. You see that this is indeed not bad. This is like clip on the interface. But the reason for that is I have lots of stream traces. This is related to the resolution of this filter. But as you can see, that you can deal with that very similar to other filters, to other, you know, contour plots in this graphical, in this layout of ParaView, that you can select multiple variables, but also some other stuff is added to this, because this is vector, is added to these stream traces. So you can see that there are new variables here, vorticity, rotation, and this kind of stuff. But we don't want to deal with them. What is really important for us is this resolution. So I reduce it to 10 times less. It becomes something like this, which is much better as a resolution. But you can see that this is indeed something 2D. I'm not interested in that. I want to have something 3D. But before going for that, You can change the source type, but I want to show you how you can deal with this line. You can change it to, you know, different locations, and then you will have, for example, stream traces generated from that part. But if you want to control it in a precise way, it's always better to turn the whole data on and also switch the camera. Or in this case, you can see that this is the second bottom, and it's, I think, X component is -7. So also I use, I enter -7 for that. So this is indeed, so the origin is somewhere here in the simulation setup, and -7 means somewhere in for the inlet. And then, to adjust it in a more precise way, I can, you know, change the camera, rotate the camera. I think this is indeed not bad for us. But this is in the outlet, this is in the inlet. So here, when I rotate the camera, then it allows me to change it without modifying, for example, the value of the x-axis. So you can see that I can freely move it around without being without making any changes to the value of the x-axis, which is crucial for me in this case. And then I can click apply, and then by hiding this, you can see that, yeah, this is indeed something that is generated. But how we can have more like 3D stream traces around, like the figure that I showed you, that we aim to create. In order to do that, we should change the source type. I think what's the name of that? Seed type. The seed type of the stream trace to point source instead of the line source. So this is indeed a line source, but a point source is something like this. You can see that we have a sphere. And by using that, we can place this sphere somewhere, and it acts as the point data for us. When I click apply, you can see, yeah, that's indeed what we wanted to have exactly. But apparently it is not in the center. So similar to the previous trick, we should enable this one and then change the camera to this and come back. And the center is -7, and I can say that, yeah, this is indeed 0 and 0 exactly in the center, and the radius allows me to, let me apply it, and then we can change radius on a fly, allows me to have, for example, a bigger sphere as the source, as the point source. So I can change it, for example, to 2. And then click apply, and you see that we will have more more streamlines around this. So that is nice. And as I told you, you can have multiple representation. In this case, this is the velocity, magnitude of velocity, or you can have, for example, the U component. This is indeed the velocity along the x-axis. But as you can see here, the stream traces are a bit thicker. In order to make them thick, we should apply another filter to these stream traces, which is indeed a tube. So tube makes lines or these kind of 2D or 1D entities a bit thicker. I click apply to see what happens. So this is indeed very thick, and I have to change this thickness. But also what I can do is I can link the thickness to another entity. That can also be nice, but in this case I don't want to do that, so I just change the radius to something smaller. So as you can see, this makes them much smaller, and then this is indeed the representation that we wanted to have. So this is indeed nice, and then you should decide that which kind of entities and variables you want to plot on this stream traces. And as I told you in the previous video, if you have like a series of data, you can have a nice animation out of this. I didn't put this the series of data here because then it would become very intensive, like 20 gigabyte, 30 gigabytes of files. So I just put one time step of this simulation, but indeed the real simulation is this the implicit surface degrading and the fluid around it evolving. And that is indeed what we will discuss in the theory section videos later. But yeah, that's it. And I, even to make it simpler, exactly similar to this, what I did was indeed plotting the velocity here, and you know how to make this color map bold. In the previous video, you can make them bold here, and then you can type whatever you want here as this one. And also something that I haven't covered in previous videos is indeed the background. If you want to make the background in another color, you can use this button. Or there is something else also in the settings, but yeah, I can say that I want a black background, which is indeed much better for my case due to the colors that I have here and the representation that I want to show. And finally, I can maybe change the color map to something with more colors. And yeah, that's it. That's indeed what we wanted to do, what we wanted to create in ParaView for stream traces. So the same principle can be applied to any other fields or any other types of fluid flow in 3D objects or 2D objects. So try to reproduce this from the data you can download. And I put the link in the description. So enjoy it. See you later.